rings the bell to start the round. Needs to put some combination work together. One punch is good, two punches better. Hey, those punches add up. So much pre-hype surrounding this fight, the fans are on the edge of their seats.
So hot and so heat, there's a roof on here, you don't understand. You're working. When the noise is there, the pressure's on your thirst, you're sweating and you're getting under. You're on the wrong side of a beating. This can be hellfire on earth.
They are not going to let this one go to the judges. And caught him with a left hook. Johnny, you would know this better than me, but I would hate fighting someone with this swarmer style. They don't let you breathe. They don't let you get off the ropes. You can't get your offense off. You just got to deal with them.
A swarmer, a good swarmer, can get inside you like a bee just pickpocketing and stinging you whenever you leave yourself open. A swarmer is the worst kind of fight to fight.
For those who thought this would be a mismatch, you are sorely wrong.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. Julio Cesar Chavez just got rocked. Just one punch away from turning his fortunes around.
3 days now needs to steady the pace. Get the pace back to normal.
How about that time counter shot? Good counter punching. Missing with the hook. Nobody home with that hook. Just missed. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Let's talk about Chavez in that last round. You know that bell was sweet music to his ears. We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. Let's see how they bounce back here in this round.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him. Tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
The counter lands. When you're fighting a counterpuncher, the feint can be such a good weapon. Pretend you're gonna punch, make the counterpuncher throw a punch, and then you counter them.
You're fighting a counterpuncher, you've got a dummy shot. Make them react from that, then react them. I know it's hard to think that way, but
and Regis Prograis in trouble. Their feet, but is this the beginning of the end?
Some fighters, when this happens, this can be heartbreaking. Some fighters, it makes them angry. They want to get back into the mix again. I want to know, what sort of character are we looking at here?
Halfway through the round, and they've got some work to do to get back into it. They both want a knockout, you can tell.
Not the best start, but you know what? The tournament now is down for them doing their job. Get through the round, regroup, freshen up, boom. Different tactics.
sleeping on the job. What do? You step back, steady yourself, recompose yourself, then boom, back into it. Do not make those mistakes. This is the wrong place to fall asleep.
Punch, counterpunch. And so far, the offense has been better than the defense. The straight right just misses. As we enter the final 10 seconds here, it's probably around you'd rather forget. Let's talk about Regis Progray in that last round. It's not over till it's over, but that knockdown is going to be huge.
You're being put.
They ring the bell.
I never curl up.
See how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
What a knockdown. 1 minute. You need 1 hour to get over a shot like that. Now it's down to conditioning. Now it's down to mental strength and preparation. It's how you are going to do it.
Just based on the hand speed and the foot movement. So impressive to watch. A straight right just misses. They both want to highlight real knockout. Can't land the jab there. So far, Johnny.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for those pointed areas over the eyebrow, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them skin and go for speed.
These two lightweights are showing you why they are the best of the best. Fourth they go in this round. The momentum continues to shift. Both men step back for just a moment.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill. Tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them. More than happy.
Just misses with that uppercut. Johnny, you know, in the lightweight division, they've got fast hands, so get ready to see some lightning.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Punch, counter punch. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. Ay, caramba! Julio Cesar Chavez in trouble! Let's talk about Chavez in that last round. What a huge momentum swing that's going to be, considering that round will be 10-8 after the knockdown.
Can make or break a fighter.
It's now important now. Nate's knees shattered. Come on, look across at him. Look at him now. Work behind the jab and then get your shots in. Don't. It's so important now that in the first minute of this next round, you get on top of it. Just keep on top of him and don't let him back into the fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's going to be stressing about his gas tank. Now keep whacking him to the body. Every time he takes a big deep breath, bang.
Don't let him get back into the fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's going to be.
He's on his last legs. Don't let him back into the fight.
Taking away that air. Every time you see him get a big deep breath, bang him down.
Keep him busy with a jab. Work behind the jab and then get your shots in.
Don't let him get back into this fight. It's so
time winding down as we get set to jump back in the action.
And don't let him back into the fight.
Work him behind the jab and then let.
the bell to start the round. Gotta get the momentum shift coming their way. What can they do here?
Todd, listen to me. If I knock somebody down like that, that round, you know this round coming up? He's getting everything over because I know his legs are gone. So this, you watch what's going on. If he doesn't, I'll be very, very surprised.
Perfect catch. Oh, Progray just got rocked. Back on their feet, but how long will they stay there?
The corner needs to think nice and sharp. They know their fight. They know what their fight is capable of doing and what their fight can and cannot make. This is going to be a tough decision to make.
Regis Progray's in trouble. Need to turn this around halfway through. At some point, the corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down.
He's got to waste time. Gets the injury referee. When he comes close, tie him up. The referee's then got to fire you.